This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Are you ready for the end of life of Adobe Flash in your environment? Microsoft recently announced that they are planning to phase out Flash support in its operating system by the end of 2020. As more firms and websites are moving to HTML5, WebGL, and WebAssembly, the need for Flash has diminished to an all-time low. Microsoft is ending support for Adobe Flash Player on Microsoft Edge, both the new and the legacy, as well as Internet Explorer 11. In the fall of 2020, an update titled as Update for Removal of Adobe Flash Player will be made available via Microsoft Update Catalog, Windows Update, and with SUS. In the summer of 2021, all APIs, group policies, and user interfaces that specifically govern the behavior of Adobe Flash Player will be removed from Microsoft Legacy and Internet Explorer via the latest cumulative update on the Windows 10 platform at that time. Currently, when you go to a page that has an Adobe Flash, you'll get a pop-up in the corner saying a pop plugin has been blocked. Edge, the new Edge, based on Chromium, currently blocks Flash because they know they're going to be phasing out Flash. Internet Explorer still supports it, as well as old Edge. So what happens if you're an enterprise that relies on Flash for some line of business application? You do have some options. First off, Adobe has indicated that you can reach out to their vendor. They are working with licensing partner Harman to provide enterprises with support and security options for Flash. Then you'll want to look at some configuration options that will allow you to control some of the notifications. Starting with the June 2020 release of Flash, you can configure Flash Player to only allow content from a list of allowed websites. You can explicitly allow Flash on content you trust and block all other content. Remember, in the new Edge, based on Chromium, Flash is disabled by default. Chrome, in particular, is starting to also block it by default as well. Now, you can go one farther and proactively disable Flash now in your Windows Edge deployments to ensure that no one is able to use it. To do so, you'll want to review the group policy settings and download the proper ADM file into your central store settings. The group policy setting for Edge is underneath Administrative Templates, Windows Components, Microsoft Edge, and you can see it says Allow Adobe Flash. If you do not want employees to use it in your office environment, you can click on Disabled and it will stop them using Flash in your environments. Flash isn't the only platform that's also getting to be to the end of its life. Recently, the Center for Internet Security released on its blog site an end of support software report list. They do this once a month, and in the August 2020 version of the listing, you can see that Office 2010 is also coming to its end of life in October of 2020. To be exact, after October 13th of 2020, Office 2010 will no longer receive security updates. Microsoft tracks its end-of-life software on their websites, and they offer several listings, including also Office for Macintosh as well, for 2016 version is coming to its end of life. Office in particular is risky to be running after its end of life. Office is often used by attackers to gain more access to a system. Typically, every month, Office has at least one remote code execution. Its macros are being used in attacks. Its preview panes often are used in attacks. Bottom line, running on Office 2010 after October 13th is going to be very unwise and very risky. You would need to make sure any machine that is still running on Office 10 does not have access to the internet or does not talk to another system that has access to the internet. Bottom line, it's not wise to be running end-of-life software after the due date goes by. After October 13th, 2020, your risk level will slowly and steadily grow as more and more vulnerabilities will be discovered in Office 2010 and you won't be patched for it. Take the time to review your organization for any out-of-date or soon-to-be-out-of-date software. Examine your options and review what risk you face from the software you're running on your systems. Take an inventory. Know what risk you're facing. Out-of-date software that is not patched anymore can leave you extremely at risk. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Check out more videos on the YouTube video channel, IDG Tech Talk. Thanks and stay safe.